there's a concept that has really impacted us. We learned about it many, many years ago from a mentor and a friend who really began to introduce us to this concept, and it made a very big difference. I know in my life, and I know in your life, as we make sense of it, and it's kind of a fancy word that psychologists use, but the word is dialectics, right? And a dialectic is a mutual and opposing force that finds its meaning in the other. And that sounds like a confusing definition, but I'm going to say it one more time because I want the listeners to truly understand this concept, because it sets the tone for everything we're going to talk about today. A dialectic is a mutual and opposing force that finds its meaning in the other. And what that means is that when two people come together in a relationship, there's going to be some forces that oppose each other that they may not feel on the front end or in the beginning, but eventually these forces are felt, and sometimes they're felt with a vengeance, right? So for instance, one of the classic forces, and I want you to kind of talk about what some of the tension, because you have what are called dialectical tensions that get created. One of those forces is the extroversion-introversion tension, mm-hmm. right? Talk about that for just a minute. What is that dynamic, and what is the tension that can be created from that particular dialectic?
Mm-hmm. You know, the funny thing about that particular one is that it's often the very thing that draws a couple together. Mm-hmm. You know, I was attracted to you because you're so different than me when it comes to just people and energy and excitement and spontaneity. But then over time, that very thing begins to be one of the hardest components, right, when it comes to compatibility, because you oftentimes are so different when it comes to social encounters, for example. I think that might be one of the biggest, challenges. I say challenges. One of the biggest awarenesses that we've had is that you are super, super social, and you want to talk to any person that you can. If you're out at the store, or you run into someone, or you're at church, or whatever it is that we're doing, you really thrive on that. Mm-hmm. And it's not that I don't like people, but, you know, I've been known to, you know, duck in the aisle at the grocery store because I might not be in a place that I want to be social. And so I think that, you know, that has presented itself at times when it comes to social outings or Christmas parties or staying at home versus going out and meeting people and that sort of thing. And we've had to really flex, because what energizes you sometimes is hard for me or exhausting for me. Right. And so I think that, we've really had to learn to be amenable to the other and be discomforted.
Right. Right, absolutely. Yeah, you've said to me many times that the idea of doing some of what I do, which is I'll do 8 or 10 coaching sessions in a day.
Yeah.
And to you, that would just be death. Because it's exhausting.
Well, that might be a little bit exaggerated.
Yeah, but it drains you. Sure. It drains you faster, right? So introversion, ultimately, the battery drains quicker. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean that they don't enjoy being around people. Mm-hmm. It just means that there's a limit to mm-hmm. how long that can go before they really begin to find themselves being drained and need to get alone again. Mm-hmm. Whereas the extrovert, that's where their battery gets plugged in.
Yeah.
Just being around people and groups, and just that energy fuels them. And so this is what's called a dialectical tension, because they are mutual and opposing forces, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, they oppose each other, mm-hmm. the introversion and the extroversion, mm-hmm. but they're mutual because they work together. That's why they, like you said, they can find themselves attracted to each other early on. Mm-hmm. The problem is that when the tension arises, somehow you've got to figure out, how do you resolve this thing?
Right.
How does this thing work together so that it now doesn't cause this polarization between these two people?
Right. Because oftentimes I think what happens is you begin to resent the other person and you want them to be like you. Why can't they be more like me? Because then it would just be easier if we both were social, or if we both, you know, were more similar in that way. And that's kind of an easy out. But you and I both know that that's not really realistic. Right.
Yeah, that's
right. And so you have to find ways to appreciate what's important to the other person, which sounds so simple, but so difficult to do.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, it is.
And so it requires real growth and stretching. And I think we have to be stretched and get out of our comfort zone. So there's times that we're going to stay late at a party because I know you're having a great time.
Yeah.
You know,
that's right.
Or you're going to say, you know what, let's go, sweetie, because you know that I'm ready. And, you know, we have to kind of work at that. And it doesn't always look perfect, you know, but.
Right. Yeah, it's a little bit like what you just described really well as this concept of unenforceable rules.
Yeah.
Like for me to enforce a rule on you to be more of what I need you to be in order for me to not feel so much tension, that's not very enforceable. I might try to force you to be different and it doesn't work very well. What I can do is I can enforce rules on me. Yeah. Like you just said, I can try to move down that dialectical scale towards you, but to force you and expect you to move down the scale towards me, that's unenforceable. And that's where the problem arises, yeah. Right? It's when both people try to get the other person to be more like them,
right?
As opposed to them trying to become more like the other.
Mm-hmm.
It's subtle, but it's a major distinction between the two. So that's one very common, what we call dialectical tension that exists. You and I one time, remember we made a list of all of our friends that we know that have an extroversion, introversion combination.
Yeah, it had to have been like 90% of our list. Yeah, which is absolutely so interesting.
Isn't that interesting? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we started laughing. You begin to look at this and you're like, look at this. I mean, we could name the names right now of the people who are on both sides of the scale. And you know that they've got their own in-house tension